Now we are discussing the technique to improve the QoS, which is the traffic shaping. We know that in the network, the quality is very much important. Quality in terms of what is the performance, what is the speed, how much delay the network takes. Now to improve all these parameters, we are having different techniques like scheduling, traffic shaping, resource reservation, admission control. So here we are discussing the technique, which is the traffic shaping. So in the improving quality of service, we are having the traffic shaping as a technique, which is further having the mechanism like leaky bucket and the token bucket. So first of all, we understand what is the traffic shaping. Traffic shaping is a mechanism to control the amount and the rate of traffic sent to the network. Means how much rate or how much data that can pass through the traffic, that is taken care by the traffic shaping. Means how much traffic we can pass through the network, that is taken care by the traffic shaping mechanism. There are two types of traffic shaping mechanism which are available. The first one we are having is the leaky bucket, and the second one we are having is the token bucket. So these are the two mechanism. Now we are going to discuss the first mechanism, which one is the leaky bucket. Now we are discussing the first mechanism of traffic shaping, which is the leaky bucket. So you can see that there is a diagram where we are having a tap. To understand this, we are taking this diagram. Now the tap is available. You can see that from the tap the water is flowing, and this water is coming inside the bucket. So this one is our bucket, and the name of bucket is given as the leaky bucket, because at the bottom of the bucket there is a hole. Now understand the concept. The concept says that you can see the from the hole the data is coming out. That means if we take the real life example, let us suppose that we are having a leaky bucket, from that the water is coming out. Now the hole is of fixed size. That's why the water which is coming is having the fixed flow. So whatever the water will come here, it is having the fixed flow. But from the tap, the water can come at any of the flow. Means there is no restriction, because at the top side of the bucket, it is having the open. Now here the water will come inside and fill. That means from the tap, we can have the bursty flow. Means bursty water can come inside the bucket, but from the bucket, the water which will come out, it is having the fixed flow. The same concept is taken in the traffic shaping by the help of the leaky bucket. If we are putting the data into the buffer, let us suppose that this leaky bucket is like some buffer. Now here we are not putting the water, we are putting the data inside. Now that data can come at any of the flow. Any of the flow means it can be having the bursty data, but at the outside the data will come at the fixed flow. So the bursty data will be converted to the fixed flow data. So that is the concept behind the leaky bucket. Means in the bucket we are putting the water at any of the speed. Maybe if we are saying that it can be of 100 Mbps, 20 Mbps, any of the speed the data is coming, but whenever the data will come out, it will be having the fixed flow. So that is the concept behind the leaky bucket. So we can say that the input rate can vary, but output rate remains the constant. Just like the water can come at any of the speed, but water will come out at the fixed speed. Similarly, input data can come at any of the speed, but output data will be at the constant speed. So we can say that it smooths out the bursty traffic. Smoothing the traffic means shaping the traffic. That's why the name is the traffic shaping. Here the bursty chunks are stored in a bucket and sent out at the average rate. So here the bursty data will come and it will come out at the average rate, means the fixed rate will come. Now to understand how it is coming into the real life, we are going to take the example with the help of the diagram. We can see that in the example, there are first 2 seconds. In first 2 seconds, the sender has sent a very huge amount of data, and the huge amount of data is 12 Mbps. So first two, second we are having the data. Let's calculate this. Let us suppose that this 12 Mbps of data is sent for the 2 seconds. So it is multiplied by the 2 seconds. Now afterward, for the next consecutive 5 seconds, it is become silent. So here you can see that it is silent from 2 to 7. For next 5 seconds, it is silent. So this is the silent time where nothing is sent. So we are not considering this time because there is nothing is sent. Now afterward, again, we are having the 2 Mbps of data which is sent by the sender, and that is for the consecutive 3 seconds. From 7 to 10, it is the 3 seconds. So we can say that the 2 Mbps of data is sent for consecutive 3 seconds. Now, these are the combined terms. So we are combining together. Means 12 Mbps data is sent for 2 seconds. So we can say that 12, if you multiply with 2, then that will become 24 MB. So this is the 24 MB of data is sent. Now plus we are having the silent time. Silent time means there is nothing is sent, so that is 0. Then afterward we have taken this 2 Mbps for the 3 seconds. So that will become 2 into 3, so that will be 6 MB of the data. So now if we combine this complete data, then that will be equal to nothing but 30 MB of the data. Means in the whole flow, we have sent the 30 MB of data, but this is the variable data. We can see that for some specific time, we have sent the 12 MB of data. Then for some time, we have sent nothing. Then afterward, again, we have sent 2 Mbps of data. So this is the variable data. But at the result, we want the fixed data. So how we can convert this to the fixed data? Now this 30 MB can be divided back. You can see that how much complete time we are taking. It is from 0 to 10, means 10 seconds of the data we are taking. So we can easily combine this one. 30 can be divided into simply 3 Mbps of data. And that is for the 10 seconds. So we can divide it like this. First of all, we have combined this data together and the equivalent becomes, that is 30 MB. Now this 30 MB can be again divided into the specific time through which the data is sent, that is 3 Mbps for the 10 seconds. Now you can see that in the resultant image, we are having the fixed data rate. And that is of 3 Mbps. So first of all, we have collected the bursty data. Now that bursty data is combined and afterward that is sent for the transmission. So the initially, if we was having the bursty data means sometimes sender is sending, sometime it is not sending. So we are taking this one as the bursty data, and this bursty data we are taking here means you can assume that sometime the water tap is open, sometime it is not open. We are storing the water into a bucket. Similarly, 12 Mbps of data is coming, then silent, then 2 Mbps is coming. We are storing them together into a bucket. Then afterward, this bursty flow is converted to the fixed flow. Similarly, this bursty flow is converted to the fixed rate of data. Now, whatever the data is sent specifically, that is converted back to the fixed data rate. So there we will achieve the speed of 3 Mbps here. So that is the concept behind the leaky bucket. And with the help of this bucket, we can easily convert the bursty flow into the fixed flow. Now there is one more case. Let us suppose that the tap is going to fill out the bucket, but the bucket is full. If the bucket is full, if the leaky bucket may drop the packet, if the bucket is full. So those packets which are coming extra will be dropped. Or we can say that the leaky bucket may drop the packet if the bucket is full. Now we are understanding that how the leaky bucket can be implemented. So here we can see that there is a queue. Now this queue is nothing but a buffer. So this buffer is acting like the bucket. So from this buffer, the data can come. Now, first of all, we are having the data which is coming inside, that is called the arrival. So data will come here. Now data will be checked that if the bucket is full or not. If the bucket is full, bucket means the buffer here. So if the buffer or the queue is full, then obviously the packet will be discarded, it will come downside. If the queue is empty, means some space is available, means bucket is not full or the queue is not full, the data will come here in this direction. Now the data is keep on storing into the queue. Here queue or the buffer is acting like the bucket. So in this bucket or the queue, the data is keep on storing. Now on the other side, we are having the processor. Processor is the router that is going to remove the packet at the constant speed. Means this processor is having the clear cut algorithm, which is called the leaky bucket algorithm. So based upon the leaky bucket algorithm, the output flow is fixed. Means processor will take out the data at the fixed speed. Means data come here at any of the way. Means if the data is coming, the rate is the variable rate, or we can say that here the bursty flow is coming. So in this queue, the data is coming at the bursty flow or the variable rate, but from this queue, the data will come out and that will be the fixed flow. This flow is fixed because the processor is very intelligent and it is based upon the leaky bucket algorithm that it will remove the packet at the constant rate. So now those packet will be the departure. Departure means they will come out. So this is the way the leaky bucket can be implemented. Means the queue will be taking the data at any of the speed, but from the queue data will be taken out at the constant speed. So that is how the leaky bucket algorithm works for the traffic shaping. Here we can see that the traffic is perfectly shaped. Now the next algorithm or the technique in the traffic shaping we are having is the token bucket. Now, token bucket is taken because of the disadvantages of leaky bucket. So first of all, we are discussing the disadvantages of leaky bucket. So if we talk about the disadvantages of the leaky bucket, then here the leaky bucket is very restrictive. Restrictive in the sense there are so many things imposed that it should be like this, it should not be like this. So there are so many restrictions on working of the leaky bucket. And second thing, that it do not credit an ideal host. Not credit ideal host means whenever the sender is not going to send the data, that is called the ideal time. Now there is no provision given in the leaky bucket that what should we do in that ideal time. Are we giving some advantage to the host if the host is ideal? Or what should we do with that? So that thing is not taken care into the leaky bucket. We can assume the case that let us suppose the host is not sending some data. What the leaky bucket do? Leaky bucket will empty itself. So if the host is not sending for a while, then the bucket becomes empty. Now assume one more case. Now if the host has the bursty data, it allows only at the average rate. So in this whole process, the time when the host was ideal is not taken into the account. Now to understand this, I am taking the example. Let us suppose I am a sender. Now what is the concept of leaky bucket? Leaky bucket says that whenever the data or the bursty data comes, it converts to the fixed flow. Assume I am the sender. I am just sending the data, maybe few MBs of data. Now afterward I become ideal. I am doing some other task. What the leaky bucket will do? Leaky bucket is continuously flowing because this is a leaky bucket. Now what will happen? Until I was waiting, the whole bucket is empty because I am just like a tap. I am not putting any water into the bucket. And the bucket is constantly leaking. So what will happen? The bucket will be empty. I was waiting for a few minutes, the bucket is empty. Now again I send with the huge amount of data. Now what will happen? With my huge amount of data, now as per the average, the bucket will again keep on flowing. So that means at that time I was ideal. That is not taken into the consideration. You can assume that the tap is open, the water is coming into the bucket. Now the tap is closed, the water is not coming. But in this specific time, the bucket is keep on putting the water and the bucket becomes empty. Now again we are putting so much water, again the bucket is keep on full coming. So again it will come on the average rate. So means whenever the tap was closed or sender was the ideal, that amount is not taken into the consideration. So there should be some specific principle so that whenever the host is not sending the data into the bucket, for that there should be some credibility given to the host. So it is becoming very restrictive. Means it will keep on giving the data. So these are the disadvantages of the leaky bucket. Because of this problem, we are having the next type of bucket, which is the token bucket. So now to improve the quality of service of the network, under the traffic shaping, we are discussing the next type of bucket, which is the token bucket. So under the traffic shaping, now we are discussing the token bucket. Now as the name signifies, token bucket. So in the bucket, the tokens are generated. The token bucket allows the ideal host to accumulate credit for the future in the form of the tokens. Means whenever the host is ideal, at that time the credit is given to the host, and host has given with some of the tokens that the host can use later on for the communication. So here in the token bucket, the tokens are generated when the host is ideal, and host can use those tokens later on. For each tick of the clock, system send n token to the bucket. Each tick means every second. So every second, n number of tokens are sent to the bucket. The system remove one token for every byte of data is sent. Let us suppose we are taking the example. Let us suppose that the time for the host which was ideal is 100 tick. And we assume that the n means the number of tokens which are collected every tick, and that n is equal to 100. So that means this n is 100, means every tick the tokens collected will be 100. So the total number of tokens collected by the bucket will be 100 into 100. So tokens collected are 100 into 100, because we know that every tick the n number of tokens are generated and the value of n is 100, and the host was ideal for the 100 ticks. That means 100 into 100, these many tokens are generated. So we can say that 10000 tokens are collected by the bucket when the host was ideal. When in the bucket the tokens become zero, then the host cannot send any data. So here we can see that whenever the host become ideal, the tokens are given to the host. Now with these tokens, the host can send the data. When the tokens become zero, host cannot send the data, and again it becomes the ideal. Now again in that ideal time, the tokens are given, then again host can send the data. So this way the tokens are generated and consumed, and this way the token bucket work. The token bucket allows the bursty traffic at the regulated maximum speed. Means the bursty data is taken. Now at the constant regulated speed, which is the maximum speed, the data is coming out. Now to understand this, we are taking this diagram. In this diagram, we can see that there is a bucket, and in this bucket, the tokens are present. Now these tokens comes whenever the host become ideal. So here, one token added per tick. Let us suppose that we have assumed the value of n is 1. So here, one token will be added at every tick. Means every second one token is added into the bucket. So here the token will be added. Whenever the host is ideal, then the tokens are added into the token bucket. Now in this bucket we are having the tokens. Now here we can see that Arrival. Arrival means, first of all, the packets will be coming. Now here, if the queue is full, queue is a buffer, if that buffer is full, then these packets will be discarded, it will come out because there is no space. If there is a space in queue, then those packets will be stored inside the queue. So let us suppose that we have stored certain packets into the queue. Now the processor or the router will take out the packet only when the tokens are available. So whenever the tokens are present, we can see that into the bucket there are many tokens. So first of all, one token will be taken out of the present tokens. So this one token is taken out, one token removed and discarded per cell transmitted. Means first of all, one token is taken out. Now this token is discarded and one packet will be taken from the queue by the processor, and processor will processes and this departure. Means if the token is available, only then processor will take out the packet from the queue. So this is how the token bucket work. In the token buckets, tokens are generated when the host is ideal. So host was ideal for some time, the tokens are there into the bucket. Afterward, processor takes out token one by one, and for every token it takes out the packet from the queue and process it. If the tokens are not present, processor will not process any of the packet. So this is how the token bucket works. So here we have learned the leaky bucket and the token bucket. There is one more provision that we can combine the token bucket and the leaky bucket. The two techniques can be combined to credit an ideal host and also the regulate the traffic. We know that here we are having the two diagrams. The first diagram we are having is of token bucket, and the second diagram we are having is of leaky bucket. Both the buckets are having their own features. If we talk about the token bucket, then token bucket credit the ideal host. And if we talk about the leaky bucket regulate the traffic. So these two features can be clubbed together by combining the token bucket and the leaky bucket. Means we can credit the ideal host as well as we can regulate the traffic at the same time. So these two things can be combined to achieve the best things together. The leaky bucket is applied after the token bucket, and the rate of leaky bucket need to be higher than the rate of token dropped in the bucket. If this is the scenario where we are applying the leaky bucket after the token bucket and the rate of leaky bucket is higher than the rate of tokens dropped into the bucket, then in that scenario we can achieve the two things together. The one, the credit will be given to the ideal host. Second, traffic will be regulated. So we can achieve these two things together by combining the token bucket and the leaky bucket. So that is all about the token bucket and the leaky bucket into the traffic shaping.